When you see strippers use the hashtag Team Clear Heels, they're talking about solidarity within sex worker culture. So it's not about fashion so much as it is about actually creating a community based on how we identify each other and how we see each other on different social media platforms. This is important to us because in our working world, we are often in isolation. A good example of that would be working as a stripper at night and having a day job at another place where you cannot divulge what you do at night for a living. So this creates a barrier of isolation for that worker. If you are not a sex worker, if you're not a stripper specifically, using the hashtag Team Clear Heels is kind of, I would say, like, inappropriate. And I'm not saying this to create, you know, diversion or distance with anyone here, but actually to bring a better understanding of what it means to be an ally if you're not a sex worker, but you have friends that are. So using the hashtag to speak on behalf of a worker on something that's going on in their life, even though you may feel that you're on a worker's team and being their friend and being an ally, that doesn't necessarily make you part of the team. That's something that is starting to become a big topic in conversation recently, especially with J-Lo pole dancing in the Super Bowl halftime show. You may have seen some memes where there's the idea that J-Lo is appropriating and using the image of sex workers and strippers, but not doing anything to help. I've been in this industry for a long time, and then I look over and I see someone wearing my heels and wearing my outfit, but never having done the job, and that leaves you with a certain feeling. And if you're a worker, you know what I'm talking about. And if you're not a worker, listen to this. This is how we feel sometimes. It can be very hard to be living in the role and dealing with the compartmentalization of all the other parts of your life and dealing with the isolation and dealing with all the stigmatization and now fetishization that's happening in pop culture and not having anywhere to turn and to put that. And with that comes sometimes feelings of resentment that we don't necessarily feel that we're being understood, that maybe there's a little bit of picking of the good parts of the culture that we live within and the way that we make our money, but there's no recognition given to us in the things that we still struggle with, such as censorship on social media platforms, which affects our livelihood. If you are a worker and you're feeling that burn and that resentment, I get it. You know, there is that saying, you can catch more flies with honey than you can with vinegar, right? Take the feelings that you have and remember that, you know, keep them there. We need that energy and we need that power that's within us to revolutionize when the time comes. You know, the main objective here, the end goal, is to start to get people to change their minds. And if you're putting someone in a position where immediately, as soon as they say something or they do something, they take an action on something, whether it's through ignorance or malice, hopefully not malice, and if you refute them right away, or you push back at them, or you disagree right away, no one's ever going to be persuaded to change their mind. And I know that that's hard because that puts us as workers in the position of, once again, doing more labor on the behalf of the privileged. Once again, doing more labor on the behalf of the privileged. And we have a right to feel a certain way about that. But if we put that energy in the right place, I believe that things will turn around in favor for us down the road. We just have to hold our heads high and show them everything that they think that we're not, the people that have negative opinions about us, that we're not intelligent, that we're not poised, that we don't know how to communicate ourselves. Show them that we are above that. And also create a neutral position so that we can have those conversations with people that are appropriating but don't necessarily really understand our position. Maybe just because they're innocent to it and they've never had to work within that type of environment. They don't understand what it's like. And try to take that mentality and use this as a time of not lashing out and picking at people when we don't even necessarily know their stance yet, but maybe use it as an opportunity to try to change their mind. And as weird as it sounds, try to be a little bit compassionate with them because there's something there that they don't know. And there's something that we don't know, or that we do know, right? And that means that we have more value in the situation than the people that don't know do, right? So that's just all I have to say about that. I'm really interested to see if anyone out there has an idea for like a hashtag for allies, like, you know, people that want to be involved, but don't want to step on toes. Like, if you've got something, send it my way. Thanks for watching.